Psycho Next Door, the following story is a work of fiction. I had moved to a new neighbor when I was 16. My old neighbor was full of kids my age to hang out with. We would go out and do stuff and come to each other's houses all the time. But now that I was in this new neighborhood, I did not know anybody. This all started on the first day I moved when I was unpacking myself. My mom came in the room and asked if I needed any help unpacking. I was almost done. My mom left the room and I finished. I decided to take a walk in the neighbor. It looked nice, and it was a nice day. As I was walking, I was texting and tripped on my phone, dropped on one of the neighbor's lawn. I got up and went to grab my phone when I heard a voice. "Hey kid, what are you doing?" I looked up to see an angry old man on the porch. I told him I was only trying to get my phone, but he kept yelling at me not to get on his lawn. Suddenly I heard another voice. "Relax, old man." I looked to see a boy who looked my age come next to me. "He just wants to get his phone." The old man gave the boy an angry look. I picked up my phone, and the man went inside angry. The boy looked at me. "Do not worry about him," he says. "He's just pisho." I tell him it's all right. I thank him for helping me out, and he tells me no problem. "My name's Jer," the boy tells me. "Well, it's really Jerry, but I go by Jer. What's yours?" "Elliot," I tell him. He smiles and asks me how old I am. I tell him my age, and he says that he is indeed that age as well. He asked me if I wanted to hang out and I agree. He shows me to this arcade. He says it's the best one in town. I go along with it because I like arcades myself. After a few minutes we were playing one of the games. I was in the middle of playing when I noticed this girl walking towards us. Jer has this grin on his face when he looks at her. She just gives him a dirty look and walks off. I ask him what was that all about. He tells me she was just a bitch. We continue playing games around the arcade. After a day at the arcade, I arrive home and tell Jer I will see him around. He says that I will because he lives right next door to me and points to the house to the right of mine. I smile and tell him I will see him tomorrow and head inside. The next day I get up and eat breakfast. After finishing, there's a knock on my door and I answer it. It's Jer. "Wanna hang out?" he asked. I tell him yes and go to change. We go on our way. I see a guy riding his bike, and when he rides past us he looks a little scared. I look to see Jer giving him the finger as he rides off. I look at him and ask him who that was. He said it was a kid who's given him problems. He then suggests about taking a walk in the woods. I agree. When head to the woods and walk around, I always thought it was peaceful in the woods. I do not know, it just always felt nice. This is where things started to take a weird turn. I got separated from Jer for a little bit. Once I did, I noticed rumbling noises coming from the bushes. I was alarmed. What came out of the woods shocked me. A guy that had been beaten and was bleeding was crawling out of the woods. He grabs onto me. He tells he to him in a pain-filled voice. I grab his arm and put it around my neck. I make my way to find Jer. I call his name, but I notice a look of fear in the guy's eyes. Jer came to me and immediately noticed the guy. He gave him a look. I told him we should get him to a hospital. Jer slowly nods his head, never taking his eyes off the guy. We get him to a hospital and sit in the waiting room. I tell Jer I hope the guy will be okay. Jer just turns and looks at me but says nothing. After a while he just walks out of the hospital. One of the doctors came and asked if I would like to see the guy. I tell him yes and go to his room. I asked him if he's all right. He gives a cautious look around, but then looks at me. He tells me he's fine. I asked him what his name was, and he told me it was Gary. I asked him who did this to him. Gary looks at me for a few seconds, and then says, "Jer." I look at Gary in shock. I could not believe. Gary then tells me that he's been hanging out with Jer, but wanted to stop because he found out that Jer was psycho. Not only that, but he witnessed Jer do some really strange things. He said that he told Jer he did not want to hang out anymore last night. He then told me that earlier in the morning Jer wanted knocked on his door and asked him to talk things over. Gary agreed and went. As the two were talking, Gary did not notice that they ended up in the woods. Jer then tackled him to the ground and started beating him. He then left him as he bled on the ground. I could not believe what I was hearing, and told Gary I need to go home and tell him I hope he gets well. I leave the hospital only to see Jer standing outside looking at me. He walked up to me. "What did he say to you?" he asked. "Look, man," I said, "I need to go home." What did he say to you? Jer repeats, this time in a more threatening voice. I look at him and walk away quickly. I turn around to see him just staring at me. Later on, I'm at home watching TV by myself, thinking about what happened today. Suddenly I hear a knock at my door. I look out the window, but see nobody. I then open my door, but again nobody's there. I shrug it off as me just hearing this and go back to watching TV. A few minutes later I hear a tapping coming from the kitchen window. I ignore it, thinking I'm just here ring this things. It then gets louder and I go and look out the window. Nobody was there. I know I did not hear things this time. Suddenly I hear a tapping noise coming from the window in the living room. I go back in there and look out. But this time I see someone running to the side of my house. I panic and look at every window downstairs. Nobody was there. I then decided to call the police. Just as I was about to pick up the phone, it rang. It answered. Hello? A heavy breathing noise came from the other side. Suddenly the power went off. I was really freaked out now. I was home alone with my power out at night with someone outside my house. Just then I hear glass break. I run to the kitchen and sees a hooded figure. I managed to get my cell phone out of my pocket. I was so freaked out I forgot it was in there. I turned the light on, and the figure ran towards me and tackled me to the ground. He held a knife and was using his other hand to go for a punch, but I was able to block it and kick him off of me. I ran towards the front door, but the figure grabbed me and pulled me further into the dark house. The knife was at my neck. I struggled, but elbowed him off of me as he opened a door and tried to pull me in. The figure recovered and tackled me to the door, and we fell down the stairs. I realized we just fell in the basement. I use my phone's light and see the knife. He makes a grab for it, but I kick it away. The figure then grabs me and starts to punch me, but I fight back. The figure then goes for another punch, but I block it and punch him hard in the face, sending him down. I ran out of the basement and out the front door. I go to Jer's house and knock on the door. His mom answers, and I tell her to call the police. I wait on the couch just as the police arrive. Jer's mom comes downstairs and tells me he's not in his room. I go outside and see the police coming out with the guy with his hold off. I look in horror. It was Jer. He gives me a look of hatred as he gets put into the car. His parents are in shock. The police then tell me that this is not the first problem he had with him. They told me they arrested him multiple times for assault and even stabbing someone. He also apparently did not have many friends due to this behave. He would freak out and start beating on people. I had this look of disbelief. I had been hanging out with psycho. My parents were called and they came and hugged me. Jer's family moved out not that long after. I have not seen him since, and I hope I never do. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, hit that like button to support my work. And as always, enjoy the fear, my dear.